us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. My tongue shall rejoice in thy righteousness. O Lord, thou shalt open my lips. pleasure of Zion, and let the walls of Jerusalem be builded. Then shalt thou be pleased with the sacrifice of righteousness, with the oblation and all burnt offerings. Then shall they offer the wills upon thine altar. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, look down ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to thee, O God. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Let us worship the word, O ye faithful, praising him, that with the Father and the Spirit is called beginningless God, who was born of a pure virgin, that we all be saved. For he was pleased about the cross and the flesh that he assumed, accepting us to endure death, and by his glorious rising, he also will resurrect the dead. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Thy martyr, O Lord, in the courageous contest for thee, receive as the prize the crowns of incorruption and life in thee, our immortal God, for since he possessed thy strength to cast down the tyrants and wholly destroy the demons, strengthless presumption. O Christ, God, by his prayers, save our souls, since thou art merciful, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O Theotokos, thou art the true vine that hath often poured for us the fruit of life. Thee we supplicate, intercede, O Lady, together with the apostles and all the saints, that our souls find mercy. Blessed is the Lord God, blessed is the Lord day by day. The God of our salvation shall prosper us along the way. Our God is the God of salvation. Holy God, holy mighty, holy for all have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy for all have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy for all have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O most holy Trinity, have mercy on us. O Lord, blot out our sins. O Master, pardon our iniquities. O Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities for thy name's sake. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in the heavens, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. In thy condescension, thou dost descend into Hades, O my Savior, and having broken the gates which thou art on the cross, as Creator, thou dost raise up the dead together with thyself, and thou dost break the sting of death, O Christ, and deliver Adam from the curse, O Friend of Man. Wherefore we all cry unto thee, save us, O Lord. Lord have mercy, 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 Lord have mercy. Thou at all times and in every hour and on earth be glorified, O Christ, who art long suffering, plenteous of mercy, most compassionate, who lovest the righteous and hast mercy on sinners, who call us all to salvation through the promise of the throne. Receive, O Lord, our prayers at this hour and guide our lives with thy commandments. Sanctify our souls, make chaste our bodies, correct our thoughts, purify our intentions, and deliver us from every sorrow, evil, and pain. Compass us about thy holy angels, and guided and guarded by their aid, we may attain to thee and thee our faith with the knowledge of thine unapproachable glory. For blessed art thou unto the ages of ages. Amen. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. More honorable than the cherubim, beyond compare, more glorious than the seraphim. Thee who without corruption gave this word to God, the word of the very dear God, most to be magnified. In the name of the Lord, Father, bless.
To the prayers of our only Father, the Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us.
Amen. O sovereign Master God, the Father Almighty, O Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, and thou, Holy Spirit, one God and one power, have mercy on thee, a sinner, and by the judgments which thou knowest, save me, thine unworthy servants, for blessed art thou unto the ages of ages. Amen. O come, let us worship God our King. Come, let us worship and fall down before Christ our King and God. O come, let us worship and fall down before Christ himself, our King and God. O God, in thy name, save me and thy children. for strangers are rising up against me, and wise men are sought after my soul, and have not set God before themselves. For behold, God helpeth me, and the Lord is the protector of my soul. He will bring evils upon men, and he will shall be destroyed by their truth. But if they shall sacrifice unto thee, I will confess the name of the Lord, for it is good. For out of them the affliction is now delivered me, and my eyes look down upon my enemies. Give ear, O God, unto my prayer, and stay not my supplication. Attend unto me and hear me. I was grieved in my meditation, I was troubled at the voice of the enemy and at the oppression of the sinner. Because they have turned iniquity upon me, and with wrath were they angry against me. My heart is troubled within me, and the terror of death has fallen upon me. Fear and trembling have come upon me, and darkness have covered me. And I said, who will give me wings like a dove, and I will fly to your breast. Though I have been afar off and dwelt in the wilderness, I waited for God that they would keep me faint hearted and see some tempest. Plunge them into the depths, O Lord, and divide their tongues, for I have communicated and made a saving to me. Day and night, people are not about revolving to the city of my own righteous concern, makes the good. And usury and deceit have not departed from the streets. For if mine enemy had involved me, I might have endured. And if he did hate me, had spoken both words against me, I might have put myself in him. But thou art close of my life. For thou art close of my life, and so will be my God, and I will be your friend. Thou art together with me, to see my attacks, and thou art the God I walk with thee, one is in mine. Let death come upon such ones, and let them throw down a line of graves. For wickedness is in their dwelling, sending them to death. As for me, of the God of my pride, the Lord hearken unto me. Evening, morning, and day, day, while I call it, and I will declare unto you, O hear my voice. He will redeem my soul and peace from them that draw nigh unto me. Yea, among many will wait me. God and you, God will hear you, O humble man, he that is before the ages. For to them there is no cause, because they are not pure God. They have stretched forth his hand of retribution. They have defiled his covenant. They were scattered by the wrath of his countenance, and their hearts are convened. Their words were smoother than oil, yet they are dark. Cast thy care upon the Lord, and you will nourish me. You will never forgive the wrath of his children. But thou, God, shall bring those men down and shall put in destruction. Bloody and deceitful men shall not live out half their days, but as for me, O Lord, I will hope in thee. He that dwelleth in the realm of the Most High shall abide in the shelter of the God of heaven. He shall say unto the Lord, thou art my helper, and my refuge, he is my God, and I will hope in him. For he shall deliver thee from the snare of the hunter, from every shadow of death. With the shoulder of the shield overshadowed thee, and under his wing shall thou uphold. For the shield of his truth encompass thee. Thou shalt not be afraid for terror by night, nor for the arrow that flies by day, nor for the thing that walks in darkness, nor for the mishap of thee under your gate. A thousand shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but unto thee shall not come back. Only with thine eyes shalt thou behold, and thou shalt see very wonderful. For thou, Lord, art my hope, thou madest the Most High thy refuge. No evil shall come nigh thee, and no sword shall draw nigh unto thy bow. For he shall put his angels charge over thee, and keep thee in all thy ways. On their men shall they rear thee up, lest any time thy dash they put against the stone. All the aspen baskets shalt thou tread, and thou shalt trample upon the lion and dragon. For he hath set his hope on me, and I will deliver him. I will shelter him, because he hath known my name. He shall cry unto me, and I will hearken unto him. I am with him in affliction, and I will rescue and glorify him. With length of days will I satisfy him, and I will show him my salvation. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. What a mercy, what a mercy, what a mercy. Let us worship the word, O ye faithful, praising him, that with the Father and the Spirit is co-beginningless God, who was born of a pure virgin, that he all be saved. For he was pleased to count his cross in the flesh that he assumed, accepting thus to endure death. By his glorious rising, he also will resurrect the dead. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Thy martyr, O Lord, this courageous contest for thee, received as the prize the crowns of instruction and life of thee, our immortal God. For since he possessed thy strength, he cast out the tyrants and wholly destroyed the demon and strengthened his presumption. O Christ, God, by his prayers, save our souls, because thou art merciful. Both now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Seeing that we have no boldness on account of our many sins, do thou beseech of those born of thee, O Virgin of Vocals, for the supplication of a mother availing much to the Master's favor, to stay not the prayers of sinners of those called this blood, for merciful thee and mighty save, he that died to suffer for us, let thy compassion quickly go before us, O Lord, for we are becoming taken before. Help us, O God, our Savior, for the sake of the glory of thy name. O Lord, deliver us and be gracious unto our sinners for thy name's sake. Holy God, holy mighty, holy God, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy Lord, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy Lord, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, to the Son, to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O most holy Trinity, have mercy on us. O Lord, blot out our sins, O Master, pardon our iniquities. O Holy One, visit and heal our enemies for thy name's sake. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
The mine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, unto the ages of ages.
Now, never, and unto the ages of ages. Amen.
Blessed is the kingdom of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages. Amen.
Lord, my soul, bless you.
Thank you.
Protect us and preserve us from this generation forever. Save me, O Lord, for there is no longer any that is godly. In comforting, in giving, let it be done with simplicity, in governing with diligence, in showing mercy with goodwill. Let love be without hypocrisy, abhor that which is evil, pleading to that which is good. Be kind to one another in brotherly love, treating one another with honor. Do not falter in your diligence. Remain fervent in spirit while serving the Lord. Rejoice in hope. Be patient in tribulation. Be steadfast in prayer. Keeping hospitality, fulfilling the needs of the saints. Bless them that persecute you. Bless and do not curse.
Peace be unto thee.
And to thy spirit. Hallelujah, the fifth tone. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Are forgiven, or to say, rise and walk. but that you may know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins. Then he said to the paralytic, rise, take up your bed and go home. And he rose and went home. When the crowd saw it, they marveled, and they glorified God, who had given such authority unto men.
Glory to thee, O Lord, glory to thee.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, glory to Jesus Christ.
Glory forever.
Dear brothers and sisters, in today's gospel lesson from St. Matthew, we are told the story of how Christ healed the paralytic by the power of faith. Now this story is also mentioned in the other synoptic gospels, and St. Mark and Luke tell us that there was a great crowd at the house where the Lord was teaching. And so there was such an immense amount of people that they could not bring this man through the door. So the four people carrying him lowered him through the roof. Now we can imagine what type of spectacle this could be, because the roofs in those days were not like the roofs we had. And I was pondering this week on what this roof might look like. And my wife is from the Philippines, and her grandmother lived in the province in a little hut, and they had a makeshift roof that they would make out of coconut leaves and palm leaves, and they would weave them together, and this is how they kept their shelter. So certainly there must have been some kind of roof like this in those days, because they didn't have the modern shingles and things that we have today. And so these men went through great lengths to try and open this roof so that they could lower their friend, that he might find the mercy of God. Therefore, the four men who lowered him were rewarded by Christ, because upon seeing their faith, the Lord said to the paralytic, son, be of good cheer, your sins have been forgiven thee. Blessed Theophylact commented on this, saying, the Lord called the man son, as we are all God's children, but also because of the man's belief. He first forgives the man of his sins, and then he heals him, showing that his paralysis was a result of his sins. But we must remember, of course, that not all suffering is a result directly of our individual sins. Our world and humankind are in a fallen state, and evil exists, and sometimes innocent people suffer. But in this case, we know for sure the man was paralyzed due to his sins, and that he was healed by his faith. Blessed Theophylact also points out that it was not the paralytic's faith alone, but also the man who brought him there. Therefore, the gospel says that when Jesus Christ saw their faith, this is a lesson for us on the importance of us to help carry others' burdens. God hears our petitions, and it is our duty to pray for one another, to support one another, and to show love for one another. We find this in the story of the centurion who came to ask Christ healing for his servant. Our Lord Jesus Christ said he had not found such great faith, not even in Israel, and healed the man's servant. If the centurion had never come, how could Christ have healed him? Our faith, dear brothers and sisters, can help others, and sometimes the person we pray for might not have faith. He might not even believe at all, but he needs our prayers. Now the scribes, as we read, were not happy when the Lord said to the man, thy sins be forgiven thee. And in their minds they began to accuse Christ of committing the sin of blasphemy. So the Lord reveals to them that he knows what they are thinking, and shows that he is God in four different ways. First, he says, wherefore think ye evil in your hearts? In doing this, the Lord shows that he knows their thoughts, and only God can know our thoughts. Now, sometimes God has given the saints this ability, but it is God who gives the power. It is never the saint himself. Second, by curing the man of his physical illness, he showed that his sins were also forgiven. Christ healed by his own power and his own word and showed that he was equal to God. Therefore, the visible sign of healing the body confirms the invisible sign of forgiveness or healing of the soul. As we again mentioned, the man was paralyzed because of his sins. Third, the Lord plainly tells them, but that ye may know that the Son of Man, a messianic term, hath power on earth to forgive sins. Then as a final confirmation, the Lord turns to the man and says, arise, take up your bed, and go to your house. And immediately the man arose and departed to his home. The Lord tells the man to take up his bed and go to his house to confirm even more visibly that this miracle has truly occurred, and also to show the multitudes that would see the miracle who he really was. And this is exactly what happened, because the gospel finishes saying that when the multitudes saw it, they marveled and glorified God who had given such power unto men. Now, this was a very short gospel reading with a lot of power behind it. And what are the lessons, the important lessons that God wishes to teach us today? The first and obvious answer is that we learn that faith is indispensable for our salvation. If we believe in God, if we believe that he is all-powerful and can do anything by his word alone, I will add, we believe that he is all-good, all-righteous, and desires to help us, then through him, great things can be accomplished. We remember Christ's words, assuredly I say to you, if you have faith as a grain of mustard seed, you will say to this mountain, move from here to there, and it will move, and nothing shall be impossible for you. And of course, the mountains are the difficulties in our lives, the great mountains that are in front of us, and we get overwhelmed by. In his book, My Life in Christ, St. John of Kronstadt says, there is nothing impossible unto those who believe. God is as close to us as to our own skin. Therefore, lively and unshaken faith can accomplish great miracles in the twinkling of an eye. He goes on to say that even without great faith, God is unbelievably merciful. Even without our sincere faith, miracles are accomplished every day. The miracle, of course, of the sacrament of our Lord and God and Savior Jesus Christ, body and blood. For God's mystery is always accomplished, even though we were incredulous or unbelieving at the time of its celebration. St. John goes on to quote Romans 3:3, where St. Paul says, shall their faith, shall their unbelief make the faith of God without effect? Our wickedness shall not overpower the unspeakable goodness and mercy of God. Our dullness shall not overpower God's wisdom, nor our infirmity God's omnipotence. The second lesson that we learn is that faith must be accompanied by love. An exact example given to us today by the fact that these men took this man to Christ, who had no ability to do it for himself. In 1 Corinthians 13:12, St. Paul writes, and though I have the gift of prophecy and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and though I have all faith so that I can remove mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. Then in 1 Corinthians 13:13, he tells us again that we must have faith, hope, and love, but the greatest of these is love. Love is what brought the centurion to Christ for his servant, and his faith and love combined is what brought Christ to heal him. Love is what also brought the four men to bring the paralytic to Christ, and their faith healed him. Likewise, the lack of love, pride, and superficial faith
is why many of the Jews were spiritually blind and could not see that our Lord was their promised Messiah. Now some, of course, have come to me and said, Father, I prayed for so many things, but God has not answered my prayer. Why? And then I remind them that even I struggle with this at times, but we must remember that God is all-knowing. Therefore, as I have explained many times before, faith is not only believing in God and that he is all-powerful. That is not true faith. Faith is a total trust in God when we do not understand why we are in a particular circumstance. Therefore, God gave us the stories of Abraham and Job to give us hope in times we don't have much hope. We must remember that Abraham did not understand why God would want him to sacrifice his son, but he trusted God's word when his mind did not understand it. He knew that God would never ask for something evil. Job likewise did not understand why God had allowed him to suffer, but he knew God would never do anything evil. And in the end, both he and Abraham saw God's purpose in everything. Now there is another, dear brothers and sisters, another important lesson. One that is not so obvious to us, but it explains why Christ became the God-man, why our Lord came to earth to save us. St. Athanasius the Great, who is very famous for saying God became man so that man could become like God, also reasoned as why this must have taken place. And he said, God acted because the creature he had fashioned, meaning us, in his own image and likeness, was suffering. What were we suffering from? We were suffering from the effects of sin, the fallenness of the world, our own sins. And what this really means is our own spiritual paralysis. Because there are different types of paralysis, dear brothers and sisters. Paralysis is not only our ability not to move our bodily parts. Paralysis is when we are stuck in our transgressions, when we are paralyzed by fear. There are many different forms of paralysis. And we were given this example last week because the man who was possessed had no control over his own body. He was paralyzed as a human being. The people who kicked Christ out of the town for performing such a beautiful miracle, they too were paralyzed because they loved their money and their wealth more than God's righteousness. They were not supposed to possess unclean animals. They were breaking the law of Moses, but they loved their money more than they loved God, and therefore they were possessed by their possessions. And so, dear brothers and sisters, this is the message today, that we are all possessed in some way by our sins, but Christ has come to earth as the God-man to free us from our sins, to heal us from our sins, to impart unto us his righteousness, to give us the kingdom of heaven. This is why Christ said, I have come that they may have life and that they might have it more abundantly. When he says, I have come that they may have life, he's talking about that I may take away their burdens of sickness and sorrow and suffering, but have it more abundantly is the fact that he was giving us the kingdom of God. Therefore, to show us mercy and to forgive us of our sins is exactly why Christ became man, without ceasing to be God, so that we may be restored and clothed with God's perfections. So we must remember, dear brothers and sisters, the words with which Christ healed the paralytic, thy sins be forgiven thee. This means that in bodily paralysis, the reason is often sin, but in spiritual paralysis, the reason is always sin. All we have to do is find the sin in our life that possesses us, the passion which stands before us in Christ, and take it to our Lord and say, Lord, heal me. Then the Lord will tell us, as he did the paralytic, thy sins be forgiven thee, my son and daughter. Arise, take up your bed, and go into your own house. But let us never be like those men and women last week who told Christ to go away. Because if we don't want to repent of our sins, God cannot heal us. This is the only paralysis that God cannot heal. Because he always needs a willing spirit. God will not force us to love him. God gave us free will. This is what makes us human beings and not animals. So therefore, dear brothers and sisters, if you want to be released from your sin, repent and tell Christ, and he will say to you, arise, take up your bed and walk, and I will give you life in this world, and more importantly, I will give you life more abundantly in the kingdom of heaven. Amen.
Let us sing, O Lord, whole soul, O Lord, whole mind, let us sing. Lord, have mercy. have mercy on us and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
For these have joy to the life and in your grace and the glory unto thee, to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever unto the ages of ages.
Thank you.
our great Lord and Father Kirill, the most holy patriarch of Moscow and all Russia, and our Lord, the very most Reverend Nicholas, Metropolitan of Eastern America, New York, first hierarch of the Russian Church abroad, and our Lord, most Reverend Kirill, Archbishop of San Francisco and Western America. May the Lord God remember in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
The God preserved Russian land and the suffering Ukrainian land and its Orthodox people, both in the homeland and in the diaspora. May the Lord God remember in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto the ages of ages. This land, its authorities and armed forces, and all who with faith dwell therein, may the Lord God remember in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
The clergy, the monastics, all that are persecuted of the Holy Orthodox faith, the founders, the benefactors, the brotherhood and sisterhood of this holy temple, and all of you Orthodox Christians, may the Lord God remember in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Thank you.
especially for most holy, most pure, most blessed, glorious Lady Santorco, and ever Virgin Mary.
Condemnation,
to dare to call upon me, the heavenly God as Father, and to say,
transgressing thy commandments, by not obeying thy commandments. But thou, Lord, who art not them, who the long suffering and tenderness of mercy, hast not put me over and be destroyed of my sins, but always thou waitest my complete conversion. For thou hast said, O lover of mankind, through thy prophet, for I desire not the death of the sinner, but that he should return to men. Thou desirest not, O Master, to destroy the work of thy hands, neither shall thou be the destroyer of men. He desires that all be saved and come to a knowledge of the truth. Wherefore, even though I am unworthy of heaven and earth, thou hast kept all life and happiness of the time.
With the fear of God and with faith, draw near.
Blessed is he that comes in the name of the Lord. God is the Lord and has revealed himself to us.
I believe, O Lord, and I confess that thou art truly the Christ, the Son of the living God, who came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am first.
Moreover, I believe that this is truly thy most pure body, and this is truly thine own precious blood. Wherefore I pray thee have mercy on me, and forgive my transgressions, voluntary and involuntary, whether in word or deed,
partake without condemnation of thy most pure mysteries, unto remission of sins and life everlasting. Amen. Of thy mystical supper, O Son of God, receive thee today as a communicant, for I will not speak of the mysteries of thine enemies, nor will I give thee a kiss as did Judas. But like the thief who I confess thee, remember me, O Lord of thy kingdom. May the communion of our holy mysteries be not under my judgment and condemnation, O Lord, but in the healing of all the body. Amen. A reminder that only those Orthodox Christians who have prepared themselves through prayer, fasting, repentance, and contemplation, and who have a blessing of your spiritual Father, may approach the Holy Chalice. May God richly bless you. The servant of God, beloved, partakes of the precious and his holy body of love, our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ, and the remission of our sins, and the name of the servant of God, beloved, partakes of the precious.
Thank you.
God, Anthony, to take for the precious and holy body of Christ. Our Lord God, is here, Jesus Christ, and the sins of the life of God. The servant of God, who loves him, to take for the precious and holy body of Christ.
Thank you.
and bless thine inheritance.
Shining forth from thy mouth like a beacon hath illumined the universe and disclosed to the world treasure.
covenant us and show us the heights of humility, but also instructing us by thy words, O Father God, Chrysostom, intercede with the word, Christ our God, to save our souls. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. From the heavens hast thou received divine grace, and by thy lips thou dost teach all to worship the one God in Trinity. O John, Chrysostom, all blessed and righteous one, rightly to be acclaimed thee, for thou art a teacher of revealing things divine, both now and ever and unto ages of ages. Amen. By the intercession of the Lord of all the saints and the Theotropos, do thou grant us thy peace and have mercy on us, since thou alone art compassionate. Lord have mercy, 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 Lord have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. More honorable than the cherubim, and beyond compare, more glorious than the seraphim. He who without correction gave his birth to God, the Lord, the very Theotokos, be to be magnified. In the name of the Lord, Father, bless.
Through the prayers of the Holy Father, the Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us.